Have you ever thought of market to somebody who doesn't know about your brand? Well, you see, there's a big percentage of cold traffic waiting to solve their problems. And let's say if you are able to understand them at your fingertips, you'll be in the blue ocean. Well, how do I do that? Is to create a customer persona. A customer persona is actually a detailed description to represent your target audience. There are 5 steps of how to create it. Let's deep dive in right now. The first step to create a customer persona is to write out their demographics in the terms of give them a given name, their age group, their gender, their marital status, income level, or education. By being specific in your demographics, whoever target audience that fall under this category will be able to resonate with your copy. The second step to create a customer persona is to find out your target audience psychographics. What do I mean by that is you need to find out where are they hanging out. Are they hanging out in social media like Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, Twitter, or even TikTok? And also find out what do they like, what do they dislike, what are their interests, okay? So that if you really understand this psychographics of your customer persona, then you will able to target them efficiently. The third step to create a customer persona is to do extensive research to dig out your target audience's greatest pain points. Well, you can go to those top forums like Quora, Reddit, or even Amazon reviews, Udemy, or even social media, you know, to do some social listening to really find out and understand what keeps them awake at night. What are their greatest problems that they most worry about? So once you understand this portion of how to understand their greatest pain points, you'll be able to write copy that resonate with them. The fourth step to create a customer persona is to find out your target audience's greatest desires in terms of goals, their hopes and dreams, by doing extensive research. Okay, once you are able to do that, your target audience will feel understood, okay, and they will be more resonate and be willing to buy from you. The last step to create a good customer persona is to find out your target audience objections and what are their roles, meaning that what are your target audience skeptical about? What are their doubts in mind? What are the questions they may ask you before they want to buy? And also whether to find out they are actually the decision makers. See, so by understanding these objections and also their roles, you can save a lot of time by not targeting those people that who are non-decision makers. So if you really want to create a solid customer persona, please remember to keep this in mind. Alright, I hope you find this video useful to gain some insights of how to create a solid customer persona by using these 5 steps. Well, that's all for now, and I will see you in my next video.